I wish to do a conversation about what are the mass, the space, the time, the energy, and in a word, the seven dimensions of the physics. Essentially, they are the way in which our mind conceives the mix about the to be and the to not to be. The question of Hamlet, to be or not to be, in our system, the to be and the to not to be are mixed together in all the possible ways. Just like in our system of representation of the reality, we do by a devotee, by the artificial intelligence, which resolves the representations by two numbers, the one and the zero, mixed together in all the possible ways. This is the base, the objective base of everything. And we present in a single files of digit, in these files that are representative programs, are able to transform it in the representation of our world, which recurs to the seven fundamental dimensions of our reality. That is the mass, the time, the space, the energy, the flow, the molecule, the unitary intensity of the light, just the seven that our physics has in its disposition. So, all the qualities that we see, perceive in the world are representations. We cannot be astonished, because we perceive the world by the representation that our mind does using the five our possibilities to perceive the world. That is our eyes, our ear, the touch, and the sound, and they all are representation. The first thing to do to understand in what a way we perceive in this way is a fruit of intelligence. We must start from the to be and the to not to be, and by this two opposition we must keep all our possibility to understand, to perceive, to give form to this mix of the to be and the not to be. In what a way? In the way of a cycle. The cycle is a phenomenon that is repetitive, as a wave that contains one after the other two opposition, like the hig or the up of the wave and the down of the wave. These two opposition are the unit, as one the real one presence of the matter on the line of the equilibrium, and the not to be of the water, if we have a wave of water. This is the difference. In what is up on the line is presence matter, what is down is absent matter. Matter, anti-matter. Mass and so an expansion of the mass, that the mass isn't. Two opposition that we number using the numbers. We say n every number. So the wave that shows one after the other, this one wave is the ratio n on n, or the multiplication between the two opposition n and n raised to minus 1, that is 1 divided n. N divided n is the fundament, but we have the necessity to give a number and the fundament of this n, because our relative way to perceive starts always by a thing that exists, and afterward we, basing on it, perceive it in relative way. If there isn't this fundament of n, we cannot perceive the same n. And so the father of all the numbers that we can name n is the 10 number. By a simple consequence, when we image to have the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there is or is not there a cycle as the fundament of this N. If we start by the wave that shows one after the other the two opposition, we can to have a lot of cycles. For example, one is the cycle of 1 divided 1 plus 1 multiplied 1, because 1 divided 1 and 1 multiplied by 1 is a binary system of two opposition, as that existing between the division 1 divided n and the multiplication 1 multiplied 1. The result is 2. And 2 is the cycle of the unit. Now we can take this 2 and do the same. 2 divided 2 plus 2 multiplied 2 is 1 divided 2 divided 2 is 1. 2 multiplied 2 is 4. 1 plus 4 is 5, and so 5 is the cycle of the number 2. If we take 1 and 2 as 3 and make 3 divided 3 plus 3 multiplied by 3, we have 1 plus 9 equal 10. And so, going on, 4 is 4 divided 4, so always the unit plus the product of 4 squared. 4 squared is 16, plus 1 is 17, and so 17 is the unit of the 4 dimension. 5 multiplied 5, 25, plus 1, 26, and 26 is the cycle of the number 5. 6 multiplied 6 is 36, plus 1 is 37, and 37 is the cycle of the number 6. Number 7 multiplied 7 is 49, and plus 1 is 50. In this way, we are understanding then the unit are 2, 5, 10, 16, 26, 37, 50. And we, in this way, understand that is 10. The cycle, that is the synthesis of these cycles, because the cycle of 1 is 2, and the cycle of 3 is 10. The cycle of 1 is 2, the cycle of 2 is 5, and the 2 multiplied by 5 is 10, the cycle of the 3. The cycle of 7, that is 50, is 5 times the 10, that is the cycle of the 3. In this way, we see that the 3 dimension is the perfect number, because it is at the base of the unit, and upon this 3 we can conceive the 3 dimensionality of the world, of the space of the world: X, Epsilon, Z, the Cartesian system, representative of the reality represented by our mind, in coherence with this possibility offered by the number 3. The unit 1 is the time in which, by a point, 3 different dimension start and form the space. The absolute speed is about the space as the time, as the space is represented by 3 dimensions and the time is represented by 1 dimension. It is 3 every 1. This is the absolute speed of our world, because if this 3 dimension exists as 1, for example 1 meter, we have 1 meter cubed that exists every unit of the time that we, at the last of our study, have known as the second minute. The 1 meter cubed that exists as a full matter in 1 second is the representation of the mass full. But if we start not by the fullness of the mass, but by the unit of the mass, every unit exists in the cycle 10, and so it has to do 9 movements, as in the wave represented by the 3 number, that is by 3 divided 3 plus 3 multiplied by 3, that is 1 plus 9. 1 as the existence, conservative existence of the mass. The mass, what is the mass? What is our understanding of the mass? The mass is the resistance to be moved, to be accelerated. And it is a conservative one as the first principle of the dynamic that affirms that in every system closed, everything is always with the same mass. The second principle of the dynamic law introduces the force as what pushing the mass gets its acceleration. In this way we immediately become able to give real representation to this comprehension, to this understanding. And the mass is what exists in itself. The force is what pushes the mass. And in the representation of the dynamic, the physics has understood that there is the third principle of the action and the reaction that affirms that the force of the second principle is equal and contrary to the action that the force puts in action on the mass, accelerating it. In this way we are able to understand that everything what is understood by our mind starts from the 10th cycle. Starting from this cycle, having the presence of everything, that is of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, we are able to have the representation that is relative, that is unitary. We can take a quantity in the tens, in the ten that are the base of our understanding, and put it as the denominator of a ratio that is 10 in the sum between the two parts put in a relation. And so we, in 10 units, can have the ratio 1 on 9, 2 on 8, 3 on 7, 4 on 6, 5 on 5, 6 on 4, 7 on 3, 8 on 2, 9 on 1, 10, 1, 0. We immediately understand that until 5 on 5 there is a way. After the 5 there is the inverse way. 1, 9 and in opposition 9 on 1, 2 on 8 and 8 on 2, 3 on 7 and 7 on 3, 4 on 6 and 6 on 4. In the middle there is 5 on 5 and it is the same. 5 of 5 and 5 of 5. In this way we have the wave of opposition. In fact, we use the ratio 1 on 9 to perceive the unit of the mass forever. Why? Because why 1 divided by 9 is 0.11111 forever. We use the ratio of the ninth, 1/9, to give infinity quantity to our world, as is infinite the result of 0.11111. Starting from 2 definite quantity of 1 and 9, the real division of 1 divided 9 allows to our mind to conceive and perceive the infinite universe and the infinite decimal time. In this way, we, starting from the definite, are able to give mean that representation by our mind of the infinite space of the universe and of the infinite time. Infinite as in the future, as in the past time. In the future it is because 0.11111 is infinite going in this direction with our calculation. Infinite in the past if we annul this division and starting by the real division that is done by 1 divided 9 and annul it multiplying by 9 and having so 0.9999999, a number that is the infinite approximation to the unit, but is a unit that is not in the possibility to be perceived by us, because this 9 going in this way goes in the infinite past, and it is infinite but in a way that is the result of a real calculation. And so it is in relation with its future or its past, because this relation is a real calculation with all its rules. Acting this calculation, we can give a representation to a past always in relation with our present, and go infinitely in that direction of the past. So we have seen that by 1-9 we have the future. By 9-1 we have the past. That is what is against the future and gets in the past. But the 9-1 is the energy that is the fundament of the C2 of Einstein. Because also in the unitary formula E=mc2 of the Einstein general relativity, also in that we have that the energy is 1 when we have the product of two oppositions, 1 and amassing, unitary amassing, the other, the unitary expansion. The unitary amassing we have perceived is starting from the three dimension of the space, 3/3, the infinite, the full, the unitary expansion, starting always from that 3, is 3 × 3 is 9. 1 and 9 are the two first starting or from 0 and going to 10. The first step is +1. When we start from the 10 in its completion and go back, the first step is +9. +1 and +9 are the first step from here in this direction and from here in this direction. And so are units. In fact, 1-9 and 9-1 are ratio that use the unit to form this ratio in the 10 cycle. Well, we use the cycle formed by 2-8, that is 1/4, to have the unit of the time. The unit of the time is 1/4, as we use, for example, in the music, 4 times, because the unit is 1/4. 4/4 is the unit of our system that has in use 3 dimension for the space's representation and 1 dimension for the time representation. In this way, 4-4 is the unit. 1 on 4 is the same that 2 on 8. But 2 on 8 is the binary full representation, because the number 2 of the numerator and by the 8, that is 2 raised to 3. 2 raised to 3 is 8, and it is the complex representation, binary, because 4 plus 4. The inverse ratio, that is 8 on 2, is always complex one, and it is in its unit 4 on 1, and 4 are the 4 dimension of our space-time, of our reality. When it is 4 on 1, it is the real representation of the time going toward the future. When we have 8 on 2, we have the complex representation of the 4 going in this direction and the 4 going in the other direction. And in this way we have used the numbers in this ratio between 2 and 8, whose sum, whose addition is the same, is always the 10 cycle. 10 is the fundament. To perceive now the time. The time is formed in its representation by our mind, recurring on this ratio, that is 2 on 8. Passing to 3 on 7, whose addition is always 10, we have the ratio that our mind uses to have the perception of the space, of the three dimensions of the space. The three dimensions of the space exist on the seven movement that the three can do advancing in the ten cycle. The three is a plane, the seven is the vacuum, and so we have that three advances in the vacuum, because the unit 7 of the denominator becomes the vacuum in which the 3 can advance. Its opposition of 7 on 3 is at the base of our representation of the unitary intensity of the electromagnetism, because in the ratio 5 on 5 we have the electromagnetic representation that is formed by the electric 5 and the magnetic 5. In the Cartesian representation of the space, when we have 4 parameters starting from a point in the center, and going in this way to do a plane, a frontal plane to our perception, it is the plane in itself. When it advances toward our possibility to be perceived with the fifth axis, and so we have five components, four objective, and one as the time to have the perception, always one, and one toward our possibility to perceive, four on one are the five elements, components of our possibility. And when we have these five, we have the half part of the volume, because starting from the plane and only going toward us, we perceive the half part of the volume that is towards us and not toward another, like myself, that is in opposition in relation to me and perceives the half other part. We can say that this five is electricity and the other five is magnetism. We, on the five that we are not perceiving, perceive only the five that come toward us, toward our possibility of the perception. In this way, four on one is the flow. One on four is the time. Five on five is the electric and the magnetic. 1 9 is the mass. 9 on 1 is the Einstein C2, that is the full expansion of the mass. 2 on 8 is 1/4, is the time. And in this way we have the fundament of the possibility of our mind to use algorithms, to use these ratios to attribute to the mix between the to be and the not to be forms of representation. And it is just as we do in the computers, when we transform a string of binary dates in the vision of a movie. The world represented by that movie exists in its representation, but in the base of that representation there is the string of the binary dates 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 that are the base. Afterward is the software, is the system of the rules that are able to give representation to that string of binary dates. Our mind does just as the artificial intelligence of a computer. Our mind is a computer and it is able to start by number 1 and 0 and appoggiing on 1 and 0 is able to put in the decimal system of the representation of the space, of the time, of the mass, of the, and so going on.